You have 15 seconds to ruin a wedding. What do you do in the 15 seconds? Propose to my so. Announce a pregnancy. Just stand in the aisle and scream. Works best if you're not a child. Kiss the bride and the groom. They'll either kick my ass or question their feelings, which will then lead them to marrying me. Instead, the latter is the optimal outcome. So, in a friend's wedding, she has an uncle who is a rather large and gruff man. We're in the South, so everybody calls him Uncle Bear. We're about 15 minutes to the start the procession and the bride can't be found. So the maid of honor is rather discreetly asking around if anybody knows where she went. Uncle Bear then proceeds to holler across the sanctuary, "Hey y'all, I found less than bride, Job greater than. She didn't run off. She was just in the crapper." Quote, "Wear a white dress to the wedding and say, who the fuck is that chick up there?" Quote, "Call the groom's bride a whore." In the middle of the best man's speech, just yell, "I fucked the groom last night!" Exclamation mark. Quote, "Punch the bride, helicopter dick, object to the marriage, toe punt the flower girl into space." Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time ever, Mr. and Mrs. Bob Vance. Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. I release the bees, take a heaving shit on the floor, walk up to one of them and say, "You looked better on Tinder." Die. Start playing the Reigns of Castamere, then murder everyone. Eat the cake first before the bride and groom had a chance. I throw an open 5-gallon drum of Kool-Aid at the bride. Get naked and jump on the wedding cake. Run in and scream, "You said you would tell her she was your half-sister," to the groom. Yell out that the groom gave my sister genital warts last month. Switch the wedding rings for ring pops. Take the gnarliest 15-second shit anyone has ever done in the history of human evolution. Start stabbing. Ooh, I've actually done this. So back in 2011, I started sleeping with an ex-GF that I had unresolved feelings for still. She was engaged at the time. Kept telling me she was gonna call off the wedding and move to NYC, where I lived at the time, to be with me. This went on for a few months. We'd visit each other, have a wild weekend, be madly in love, then go our separate ways and text call nonstop until our next getaway. As the wedding date got closer and closer, and she kept putting off ending her engagement, I started getting more nervous that she wasn't going to go through with calling it off. And then when it was the week of the wedding, she finally started talking about how she wasn't sure what she should do, and who she should be with, etc., etc. So thanks to being raised on a healthy diet of movies and TV shows, I did the only reasonable thing one can do in that situation. Flew down and attended the wedding specifically so I could confess my love to her in person and steal her away from her fiancé upside down face. My plan was to make a grand gesture during the ceremony, because I was young and dumb, and also how often do you get an opportunity to do something like that in real life, right? But I didn't make it that far. I got into town 2 days before the wedding. She met me at my hotel that night after her fiancé went to bed. We boned down and then stayed up all night talking. She assured me she was gonna call it off the next day. I wake up the next day, and she's gone. She left a note saying she's having second thoughts and needs more time to think things over, and that I shouldn't come to the rehearsal dinner because she can't control her feelings around me. Obviously, I show up to the rehearsal dinner later that night, get super drunk, and end up confronting her about us a little too loudly. Her fiancé's dad overhears, starts screaming at me. Her mom interrupts and starts yelling at him, then at her. Then the fiancé gets involved, and so does my ex. And the whole thing spirals into everyone screaming at each other fairly quickly. All the while I'm confessing my love for her and trying to justify my actions. And most of the guests are watching in shock at the Jerry Springer-esque shitshow that has suddenly erupted. And that's when this other guy, we'll call him Dan for the purposes of this story, and also because I don't give a shit if he or anyone else from it actually ends up reading this, butts into the chaos and starts yelling at her about how she said he was the one and they were going to run off together, and basically a lot of the same shit she had been saying to me. Yes, this all really happened. So she runs off crying. The parents continue yelling at each other. The fiancé gets pulled aside by one of his groomsmen. And I start interrogating this Dan fellow about his relationship with her and pieced together that she had been running around with him the entire time she was having her affair with me. Needless to say, the wedding did not take place the following day. And here's the best part, 9 years later. Guess who's happily married? My ex and Dan. That's right. He may have entered the race a little late, but somehow he's the one who ended up with her. If I had to isolate the exact 15 seconds I ruined that wedding, I'd probably pick taking that seventh tequila shot and then walking up to the bride at the dessert table to confront her about our months-long affair. Although, buying a plane ticket to your ex-GF's wedding would also be a solid nominee. Edit spelling. The bride. Run over to the bride 4 seconds. Kiss the bride 3 seconds. Run to the cake 5 seconds. Destroy the cake 3 seconds. Kiss the groom. None of my family know I'm gay. Run up to the altar or whatever. Never been to a wedding, no clue what it's called. And propose to the bride. Or just connect to Bluetooth speakers and start playing STFU by Pink Guy. I must say, let the incest commence. Elope with the groom and tell him that it's okay to be gay. When the minister asks for them to say I do, get naked in the middle of the aisle, piss on the floor, gangbang, tackle the bride, groom, and priest, rabbi officiant during the vows, take all clothes off, scoot down the aisle butthole on the ground like a dog, write in the guest book dear name of the groom. I loved our special time during your bachelor party. Hope it doesn't end with that. Hot kisses from you now, you wink. This way I don't abruptly end the whole wedding party atmosphere. Free food and drinks for myself. Have a seizure. I did that at college graduation, made it start like 45 minutes late. Let it play out and watch the marriage fail. Let's face facts here. Proposals. Fooling around with the bride, groom. Whatever else is amateur hour. Step 1, drop your pants. Step 2, tear the veil off the bride's head. Step 3, floss the hell out of your bumhole with that bad boy. Step 4, by this time you have about 3 seconds, so quick as you can, wipe the veil on the dress. Job done. Walk up to the groom. Put 2 fingers to his nose. Smell this. Now you know what you're getting tonight. Punch grandma. Pay one of the altar boys to call the bride ugly. As the bride walks down the aisle, I would run up to her and say I forgot to pay her for last week's sleepover. Then forcefully thrust cash at her. Say to the one of the opposite gender, aren't you glad we had that abortion last month? It's all about timing. Whatever you do, make sure it's right around the any objections part. Bring in the groom's 16 mistresses. Hey lady, you didn't finish the blowjob you gave me last night. Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. Oh wait, you're getting married, right before the officiant is to say. You may now kiss the bride. Someone runs up in front of them and proposes to their girlfriend. Fire a nuke. Punch one of their mothers really hard. Loud talking. Almost yelling but not quite. That's a nice marriage you got there. It sure would be a shame. Shut down the bar. Commit suicide during it. Completely ruined. Turn off the organ blower as the bride begins coming down the aisle to join her groom at the altar. Shove a finger in the bride and groom at the same time while they're saying vows. What a shame the poor groom's bride is a whore. I have coronavirus. Quote, shit on the pastor. I've got a bomb planted in the building and unless I get $10,000 right now you're all coming with me. For better effect I might hold up my phone with a timer on it. Ask the bride why she was flirting with me. 15 seconds, all I need is a couple of flashbangs. You fucked your brother? Kiss the bride, then grab both the best man and the groom for the gayest damn threesome and run away. With them leaving everyone questioning what the fuck just happened. Right now, start coughing. I fucked the bride, shouted super loud. Show up, dropkick the bride, flip the cake, yell out something that neither the bride nor the groom would want to hear. Spill red wine over the wedding dress. Pee on the groom. Vomit on the bride. Very unlikely there's a backup wedding gown. Tell the groom loudly enough, I hope she can give it to you like I did. Announce I'm pregnant and it's the groom's. Run into the venue naked and yell hey. Bride's name. Come back to the broom closet, I wasn't finished yet. Tackle the groom and yell, Daddy come home. Quote, no way, yell exact same thing but tackle the bride. Yell at the bride, the best sex of my life was with you. How can you leave me for him? Start coughing, sneezing face. Have the groom arrested during the exchange of vows. So anyway, I started blasting. Stab the bride, pee on the wedding cake. Run up and vomit on the priest. Stand up and shout, I have a bomb. I just scream as loud as I can. No. Asterisk inhale for 5 seconds. Ooh. Set a fire under some chairs. As the father of the bride, you turn your speech into a 30-minute recap on the childhood hijinks of your daughter. Explaining how bad of a sports player she is. Among other things, after 25 minutes of pure torture and embarrassment, you then painfully close the speech with surprise appearances by an actress playing a French bird and a drunk Jack Sparrow, two of her childhood favorites, who deliver the couple's wedding card in embarrassing, painfully awkward fashion, a complete and utter shit show that I didn't think would ever be believed. If I hadn't recorded it all, magic starts at 23:30, winking face TLDR, I'm a wedding videographer, and I've seen some shit. I object, punch the bride in the face and say, she's a man, baby, and start trying to pull the hair off her head. Just strip naked and start shouting stuff while running around. Welcome back, guys. Play Baby Shark at max volume. Call the police. You can't have a wedding in quarantine. At the reception, pose as a stripper and ask for service payments and an extra tip for picking up the marriage certificate. Drink cold sweat, smile. Stand up and yell, but what about our baby you are carrying? Question mark. Welcome back, stink bomb. Object to everything. When throwing rice, dump a ton of it in the newlywed's car and watch the following arguments and stress as the car starts growing rice from every conceivable place. Murder the bride and the groom. Slit the bride's throat. And as she stood there at the altar all dressed in her gown of white, her face was bright as stars. A shining like I dreamed of all my life. And they kissed each other and they turned around and they saw me standing in the aisle while I did not say much, I just stood there watching as that 45 told them goodbye. LL. Piss on the champagne table. And I mean a huge piss. The kind that reek of fucking hellfire. Piss on the cake. Slam my face into the cake. Trip the bride while she's walking down the aisle and start cackling. Or do the same to a flower girl. Throw up on the bride. Start shuffling the wedding cake. Shove the whole cake in your mouth before they get the chance to cut it. I'm gonna yell, there's a bitch on the cake. Find the officiant, kick their ass. 10 seconds max. Pull my pants down and walk up to the bride and groom. Throw red wine on the bride's dress. I object! Exclamation mark! Exclamation mark! I punch the cake while yell the bride is having an affair with the best man. I then proceed to throw knives at the guests. Shit on the cake. Dress up as a deity agent. And arrest the bride. Must read. Contains evil. Kidnap the bride and take her phone. Leave a note saying you acting as her. Never loved him. That was how to do it in 15 seconds. Now for bonus, once you hear the wedding's off, you realize the bride, she doesn't know who took her or where. Then make a fake footage of him running off to a different continent because he was too embarrassed. And saying that he will take her back if they can start their life there. Then along with the footage, mail a plane ticket to the bride. Once she goes, mail the groom a letter saying never contact me. She will be in a different continent and he will never contact her. She won't have her phone to contact him. Set the church on fire. Not a funny answer, but it would certainly do it. Set the bride on fire. What are those long dresses good for anyways? Oppose the groom and bride marrying. For the ladies, during the reception, stand up and ask for everyone's attention. Chug a beer, whatever alcohol given, and announce your pregnancy. For the gentlemen, during speeches, give one and have it be all lovey-dovey about marriage. But in the last 15 seconds, direct it at your partner, and end it with a proposal. I stood up in my best friend's wedding. The groom's father was the town fire chief. I was standing next to him at the reception. He reaches around and gives me a world-class goosing in front of everyone, including his wife and my then-boyfriend. Not a pat, not a pinch, a full-on big grab. A big handful, like, asscrack was involved. He didn't let go for a while. Wasn't my fault, but holy shit, did it get awkward AF for everyone.